everyone, it's Cynthia at Create with Cynthia on the World Wide Web. And today I'm here, it's day two of my five-part video series on a maker studio products. And I hope that if you are not part of my subscription to my website and my blog posts, that you will go over to my website right now. It's createwithcynthia.com, all one word, and you can type in your email address and subscribe to my newsletter. And this five-part series that I'm doing on Maker Studio products is going to be also a five-part blog post. So everything I'm telling you here, you'll also be able to read about. So if you remember yesterday, I went to Savers and I spent $33, the bag's right here in the receipt, and I purchased a bunch of products. I purchased this really cool brown wooden vase, these ceramic pumpkins, and these trays, three trays, a black metal wire one, and then these two wooden trays. And what I told you about yesterday, just quickly to recap, was the furniture and cabinetry cleaner. And I was telling you how the first step in the process of painting anything, rescuing any piece of furniture, the first step is always to clean it. Yes, you can always use water and soap if you want, but this furniture polish, I keep calling it a furniture polish, but it's really a furniture cleaner. This cleaner is so much better than soap and water because it actually absorbs into the wood or the product and it gets rid of any wax or sealants that were previously on it. And it will help this paint adhere more readily, easier, okay? So Amy Howard is an artisan and she's been in the furniture business for over 20 years. She's an amazing woman. She's been studying this stuff and she's created these products that are just over the top, really great products to use. I've been using them since July and I love them. So I really recommend that if you're going to do anything, a furniture haul like I'm doing, where I went to the thrift store, I purchased all these items, and now I'm going to restore them into beautiful decorative pieces for my home or my space in Redwood City, or an upcoming boutique that I may go to. If you're going to do that, any project, you should spend the money on the furniture cleaner. Just use a damp cloth, lint-free is fine. So I've done that with my pieces and now it's time to paint. So today I'm going to be using the Rescue and Restore paint. It's a chalky matte finish paint and it's made by a maker studio and the color I'm choosing is Blessed. Now I'm using Blessed because it's like there's like a quarter left in the jar and I have enough to do these couple of things, one coat. Because I'm also working on some furniture pieces in my home and for my store. And those pieces are ones that I also use the Blessed with. So I know in advance that I really love the color. So what I'm gonna do is dip my brush really well into the paint and then kind of wipe it. And when you do your brush strokes on your furniture, what you wanna try and do after you get into the corners, always helpful to do first, is do long, even strokes. You want to have a good amount of paint on your brush, otherwise you're going to get a lot of streaking. So you want to do good, long strokes. Amy has some great videos on her website, a Maker Studio website, that it will actually also show you some of these same things I'm showing you. And she's been in classes after classes and she's gone to school to do this. And so when she teaches, and I'm learning so much from her, she's actually really detailed about her techniques and how she paints. So I would recommend that you do that. You can also just follow me along if you want. Practice makes perfect. And so I'm doing what I love these days and painting is something I love. And so I'm practicing and practicing and practicing so that I can become perfect at it. So any dark wood like this, there's always the chance that you're gonna have a little bit of bleed through and I can already see it in this tray.